Okay, so welcome to my third video tutorial on OpenCV C++. So in this video we'll be diving deeper into the basic libraries of OpenCV. We will know actually what we are using while making a program and what we will be using while making a program in future. So I've prepared a note here, text note here, which will be as a reference, should be acting as a reference throughout the video. So remember when we made the image loading program, which I have here, quite modified one. No, this is second tutorial. Yes. So remember here we included opencv.hpp here from opencv to opencv.hpp. okay, so first let me tell you where this opencv2 is located. Okay, so if I go into my computer and let's just go to user and then local and then include, and you see here OpenCV, OpenCV2 and other things. So here we have OpenCV2 where main include header files are kept. Okay, so if I search OpenCV here, opencv.hpp, you can see here. Okay, if you try to open it, you can go through the contents of opencv.hpp and you see it has included these files. Okay, so if the you see have opencv calip3d and other things, and it is also including other files like opencv calip3d, opencv features2d, dnn, deep neural networks, flann, and other things like that. Okay, we've used this highway or maybe not. Okay, so there are other, this is actually the OpenCV world. If you have compiled OpenCV in Windows operating system, then you have to use CMake GUI version there for simplicity. So basically what you have to do is you have to take the OpenCV world switch, okay, to just make a library which you will include, and it will include all the other libraries. So suppose you don't want to keep in mind that which library, which one of these does what. Okay, so what you can simply do is just include this opencv file, opencv /opencv.hpp, and you can simply include all of these. Okay, so that's what I have written here, include the that opencv.hpp includes all these files like open core.h, that includes old C data structures and arithmetic routines, and then core.hpp, that includes new data structures and arithmetic routines, and the next one is miniflan, and then imgproc, and then imgproc.hpp. It includes a header file, and you see some of them have .h and some of them have .hpp. So .hpps are include files for open for C++, and .h are include files from C. Now you must be wondering why we have both the C and C++ files. So yeah, if you have learned C++ or if you haven't yet, there isn't any problem. But if you have learned C++, then you must know that C is, sorry, if you have learned C, then you must know that C++ is a derivative of C. Actually, it's a superset of C, because C++ is derived from C, and it's very vast as compared to C, because many of the new things was described in C++. Now, the most interesting fact is that OpenCV was first written in C, when C++ was not introduced. OpenCV is from the time, I think, 2000s. Yes, it's from the time 2000. It's from the year in which I was born. Okay, so OpenCV was first written C, but it had some problems, some back DOS. Okay, so that were like memory management problems. Like if you are programming code in OpenCV, then you have to keep in mind that you are using some memory and you have to deallocate and allocate that memory for the user yourself, and the program doesn't do that itself. However, when C++ was introduced, the problem just flushed off because of the various routines and other things described in C++. Now you see, whenever we code, we don't have to allocate and deallocate any memory, and we don't have any memory problems. C++ already does that, and those are also defined in C++ or the OpenCV libraries. Okay, so you see, here are all the OpenCV files you can include. So we have here various things like BioInspired, Ccaleb, Core. You see Core, which we are including, and when we use Core, if I show you Core, you see core.hpp will include each and every header files here. So when I open this here, it will include each and every header file, I think. Let me just scroll down. Yes, it's include opencv.hpp. I think it's h. Yes, so it's also including other header files. So you see here that each and every header file we are including includes other header files. So there's a fast link here in between header files, and that's what you're using. So the OpenCV header file we are using, till now we have learned that OpenCV header file we are using is including these header files. And now we will see the usage of these header files. So in this video, we'll be just be doing this, and on the next video, we'll go through some more examples and some more learning steps. So this, these are, remember, we compiled contrib, OpenCV contrib here. Let me show you. Yeah, you see OpenCV contrib here. So this contains the new modules that are not yet released in this version, but they will be releasing. So you see, user contributed mode, flash detection and other things, but it includes new libraries, okay, that will be introduced in new versions of OpenCV. Okay, so if you are including contrib.hpp, the latest version, then you are up to date with OpenCV. Okay, now HiGUI and other things are for other things, like this is for, wait, I have a text file here also for other things. So you see the core libraries for the contain all the basic data types and other operations, like we defined the matrix type in OpenCV while we were making our image program. So those all were, all things were defined in this core. And when we process an image, like we put a filter on it, like grayscale, and we are loading color image, we are using this img proc. And then HiGUI, we used you see, let me show you, we used this command. This is for loading grayscale and other things. You see, you are loading IM read grayscale and IM read color, so we can read both of these. And you see a display window, named window. So this named window function is defined in this HiGUI. And other things, like if you want to load or use video files in your project, then the video library is there. Then Caleb 3D contains all the algorithms, and that will, you will need to calibrate single cameras and more than single cameras. And features 2D contains algorithms for detecting, describing and matching key point features and other things. And you don't have to keep all these things in mind. All you have to do is just include the OpenCV. I'm going through all of these just to make you know that these libraries exist actually, and you are using this actually in your OpenCV. Okay, so just to give you knowledge. Okay, so you see, we have machine learning object detect. This object detect we will be using for detecting faces and hands and other things like that. for when you will be programming, like if you have heard about Uber self-driving car and other Google self-driving cars and other things, and AI playing a game or other things, then this library is used. ML is for machine learning. If you want to do some machine learning stuffs with your OpenCV projects, like if you are into artificial intelligence, then there will be a this will help you a lot, this machine learning. And also you have to install TensorFlow, which we'll be going through in future videos, not in this video series, but that will be another video series. So we have also FLAN, stands for fast library for approximate nearest neighbors. This library contains methods you will not likely use directly, but which are used by the functions in other modules for doing nearest neighbor searches in largest datasets. So that's another thing related to, I think, machine learning. Okay, so we have GPU, photo and other things. So I will be giving you in the description, and I'm not taking that much long because I'm just reading all these things. You can read that in the description. And if you want, you can copy paste. I recommend you that whatever I give in the description, you just copy paste to note file, as those things will help you, so that you don't want to open the video each and every time you miss something. Okay, so just copy the whole description and edit the things you don't want, and then keep it, save it as a tutorial note. Okay. So that's it for today. In the next video, we will be going through some image filtering and other things, and so on. So thanks for watching my video. If you like the video, just give it a thumbs up, and if you have any problem, give a call in the comment section, and share it with your friends. And that's it.